Hello, it's Patrick here from the GarageBandGuide.com. So you've written your new magnum opus and recorded it using GarageBand. You've painstakingly tweaked and fiddled with your sounds and are left with a perfect mix. What now? How do you get your multi-track GarageBand project into iTunes or uploaded to your favourite social platforms? In this video, I'm going to show you how to do exactly that. If this is your first time here and you want to master GarageBand, improve your music, as well as learn all other kinds of useful GarageBand related stuff, then hit the subscribe button and ring the bell so you don't miss a thing. There are 7 sharing options available to you in GarageBand's share menu in the toolbar. And note that while you do have some iCloud specific options available to you, I'm not going to touch on them here, as getting to grips with using GarageBand and iCloud in tandem is a whole other kettle of fish, worthy of a video all its own. Choosing to send your song to iTunes will, surprise, surprise, have it show up in your Mac's iTunes library. Before that happens though, you'll need to decide if you want to rename your song, add metadata like artist or composer info, and whether you'd like to add it directly to an existing playlist. More importantly, you can choose whether you want your exported track to be compressed to MP3 format, or left completely uncompressed. Uncompressed files retain all the audio fidelity of the original project, but are larger in size and as such will take up more space on your storage drive. Lastly, you can export any regions you have selected, or a cycle area if active, by clicking the marked checkbox at the bottom. Selecting this option will export your project directly into GarageBand's media browser. From here, you can access your exported song from the browser in other GarageBand projects. Now, honestly, I have never used this option as I simply haven't found a use for it. I rarely, if ever, import media from the media browser itself, preferring to drag and drop from Finder or my desktop. And I think that's the story for most folks in the GarageBand community. Let me know if I'm wrong though. Leave a comment if you use GarageBand's media browser on a regular basis. Provided you have an existing account, you can upload your project directly to SoundCloud. When choosing this option, you'll be prompted to log into your SoundCloud account. Once you've done that, you'll be able to choose from a ton of options relating to your upload. Similarly to uploading to iTunes, you can rename your project and enter artist, composer, info, etc. You can also control some SoundCloud specific options here, from whether your track will be public or private, plus download and streaming options. Like exporting to iTunes, you can choose to export selected regions or a cycle area with the checkbox at the bottom. You can share either the GarageBand project file, which is great for collaborators, or a mixed down version of your song to another Mac or iOS device using AirDrop. Note that you won't be able to open a macOS created GarageBand project inside GarageBand for iOS in this fashion. You'll need to use the Share Project to iOS option to do this. More on that later. Simply select AirDrop and select the device you wish to AirDrop to from the list that pops up. You can also send either a project file or mixed down song via email. Once selected, you can change the title, adjust the compression settings if exporting as a mixed down song, and choose whether to export selected regions or the full shebang. Once done, your exported project or song will be added as an attachment to an email within your Mac's Mail app. You can also simply export your song to your Mac's hard drive. Exporting this way allows you to manually add it to iTunes or upload it to Facebook, Twitter, and other social platforms yourself. Like other exporting methods, you have a variety of options to choose from. You can even choose where on your Mac you'd like to save it to. I find that saving to desktop is always a handy option. 99.9% of the time, this is how I export my projects. Exporting the file like this gives you the freedom to pick and choose when and how your song will be shared on social media, for example. Plus, if you plan to release your song either as a single or as part of an EP or album, adding files from your desktop, documents or GarageBand folder, or wherever you choose to export it out to, is the most straightforward way to go. You can share a special GarageBand for iOS compatible version of your GarageBand project to iCloud. The project appears in the GarageBand My Songs browser on your iOS device as a new song with a single track containing a mix of the entire GarageBand for Mac project. You can then add, edit, and arrange new tracks in GarageBand for iOS, and then share the updated song back to iCloud. And then when you reopen that project in GarageBand for Mac, the new tracks are added to the original project. And there you have it, everything you need to know about exporting your projects on GarageBand for Mac. If you're just getting started with GarageBand on Mac or just want a refresh on the basics, you can grab a copy of my quick start guide completely free. I'll put a link to that down in the description below. I've been Patrick from thegarageBandguide.com, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.